Math is all around us in our daily lives, even if we don't realize it.
Hi, we are Team 9800B from Foothills Middle School.
And today we're going to take you to the future of math.
Even a decade from now, people are going to be exploring Mars. We were asked to solve a problem using math. The problem that we decided to tackle was that people are going to need a habitat on Mars. To start off our research, we decided to make a list of questions to determine the conditions on Mars.
Mars has lots of harmful radiation that can kill and injure humans. The average temperature on Mars ranges from negative 80 degrees to 70 degrees. Dust storms are also common on this planet, and the ground is made from iron, dust, and rocks.
Yes, a dome would be better. Domes are 5 times stronger and are able to survive natural disasters more than regular shaped houses.
Solar panels that current rovers use can generate up to 900 watts of energy per one day on Mars. Solar panels would be affected by the elliptical orbit of Mars. For part of the year, the sunlight the rover receives will be reduced, so the amount of power generated would also be reduced.
A machine called MOXIE can make oxygen. It converts carbon dioxide into oxygen by combining the oxygen molecules that make up carbon dioxide.
Hydrogenated DNNTs are still in testing, but they have a potential to be something that could be key in protecting habitats, spacecrafts, and humans from radiation. Scientists have been able to stretch hydrogenated DNNTs into a yarn that can be woven into spacesuits.
We would microwave it out of the soil, extract it from underground, or get it from the many ice caps that cover the poles of the planet. In a place called Utopia Planitia on Mars, there is a deposit of water. This would be good for astronauts to use on Mars if they can extract it.
After going through many drafts of the house, we determined that the total surface area of the dome is about 5,655 feet. We figured this out by finding the surface area of a sphere and dividing by 2. The first floor of our dome has a diameter of 60 feet and contains a control room, a lab, and some storage space. The lab has a total area of about 1,414 feet, and the control and storage rooms have about 707 feet. The second floor of our dome contains a kitchen, a hangout room, and an exercise room. The exercise room has a total area of 795 feet, and the kitchen and hangout rooms have an area of 398 feet. A bedroom, a bathroom, and a room for a water filter. The bedroom has a total area of about 353 feet, and the bathroom and water filter room both have an area of about 177 feet. Level 4 of the dome is just a bedroom. The area of the bedroom is about 177 feet. We found the area of each space by using the formula for the area of a circle and then dividing by the portion of the circle that the room takes up. Level 1 has a total area of 2,827 feet. Level 2 has a total area of 1,590 feet. Level 3 has a total area of 707 feet. And level 4 has a total area of 177 feet. To put this all into perspective, we made life-size measurements of what the floors would actually look like. Although moving to Mars may seem futuristic, it is just one example of how we can use math to solve problems. But who knows? Maybe the future is closer than we think.